How to care for a cat. You could have heard that cats have 9 lives. Well, maybe it is authentic. However, one issue is for sure, your cat will have a long and healthy existence with the right care. There are numerous things to consider while caring for a cat, and we're going to cover them all inside the following sections. The way to choose a cat. Choosing the right cat may be a big choice. Cats can live up to 20 years, and an easy adoption can imply a huge commitment. In this phase, we are able to show you how to discover the suitable cat. We can weigh the professionals and cons of an in-person cat as opposed to a kitten. We will also look at in which the fine region is to find a new cat, a shelter, a friend, or a stray. We are able to additionally assist fit a cat on your lifestyle so that you can have the cat that actually suits you. Selecting an indoor cat versus an out-of-doors cat. Another huge decision to make when proudly owning a cat is whether or not or no longer you may have an indoor cat or an outside cat. On this section, we are able to first explore whether or not cats need to head outdoor. Is there an advantage to letting your cat roam the community? Of path, there are many more risks inside the outside that in your house. Additionally, in case you do make the choice to let your cat outside, we will display you the safest manner to introduce your cat to the first-rate exterior. Cat feeding tips. Feeding your cat is obviously an important a part of puppy possession. In spite of everything, it's one of the few obligations that you will need to carry out every day. Genuinely remembering to put a few meals for your cat's bowl is handiest the beginning. You have to additionally decide what form of food to feed your cat. We are able to additionally look at the way to stop your cat from consuming your houseplants, and whether or not or no longer you have to deliver your cat people food. Eventually, we will additionally look at how a lot water to present your cat. Store-bought cat meals versus homemade cat food. In this phase, we are able to evaluate the advantages of save-sold cat food and homemade cat meals. Homemade cat meals has the advantage of providing you with the peace of mind that you recognize precisely what you are feeding your cat. But, in most cases, you could likely believe the medically and scientifically designed formulas of the major cat food manufacturers. We are able to evaluate the diverse types of save-bought cat meals, including kibble or moist cat meals. We will have a look at the professionals and cons of each kind, and that allows you to be best for your cat. Cat grooming tips. Cats are commonly considered to be very easy animals, and, for the most element, this is true. But this doesn't suggest that cats do now not need everyday grooming. On this phase, we are able to discuss the right grooming of your cat. First, we will speak the grooming advantages of a short-haired cat to a long-haired cat. Subsequent, we can look at whether or not you must or trying to find the assist of a professional groomer. Subsequently, we will display you how to execute right grooming at domestic, along with how to put together your cat and whilst you have to forestall. Cat bathing tips. Usually cats do no longer ought to be bathed. Aside from the occasional grooming, maximum cats are able to smooth themselves. There are a few reasons why you will have to give your cat a tub. For example, if your cat has fleas or gets sprayed with something unsightly. On this phase, we will show you the proper way to wash your cat. We can display you all the steps from getting ready all the device you may need to drying and fluffing. How to cat-proof your home. Your home may be a veritable obstacle path for you cat. Even as your cat can be capable of live happily in your property for decades without encountering an twist of fate, that doesn't suggest there might not be threat lurking round every nook. In this phase, we are able to show you all of the potential dangers that cover themselves as not unusual family items. We are able to also display you how you may make your property secure your cat and what to do if your cat eats something poisonous. Cat toys. Most cat proprietors love to look at their cat play with the diverse toys they bought them. However, a number of those toys can be dangerous in your cat. Yarn, as an example, a staple amongst cat toys for years, can in reality reason very extreme injuries. On this phase, we will display you which ones cat toys are safe to your kitty and which can be harmful. Veterinarian visits and vaccinations. Perhaps the most important step you could soak up caring for your cat is locating a reliable and competent doctor. In this segment, we are able to display a step with the aid of step technique for locating a veterinarian so one can be best for both your and your cat. We are able to permit you to realize the diverse businesses to which you can turn for vet guidelines. we are able to additionally can help you know what you ought to do before your first go to the vet. Eventually, we will have a look at tomcat vaccinations and whether they may be a should in your cat. How to pick a cat before you definitely get a cat, figure out what form of cat you need, kitten or grown-up cat, long hair or short hair, purebred or alley cat, male or woman, tabby, patched, or solid shade. In case you've were given your coronary heart set on a specific length, age, intercourse, breed, or look of cat, perform a little more studies before you got down to locate one. You might be surprised to find that the look you love would not in shape well together with your lifestyle. As an example, if you want a quiet home, a Siamese may not be the cat for you, they're infamous talkers. Likewise, a Persian is fantastic to look at, but unless you are devoted to do almost everyday grooming or to pay a professional to do it each week or so, a nice short hair cat might be a better concept. Do you travel plenty? Then you definitely need a greater mature cat, at least 8 months old or more. Cats are better nevertheless, so they can keep every other business enterprise while you are away. Cat or kitten? All and sundry loves kittens. They're lovable, humorous, and cuddly, there may be no doubt about it. But don't make the mistake that they're toddlers. By the time a kitten is ready to be far from his mother and live in your property, he can walk, run, soar, and climb like the tomcat equal of a 10-year-old infant. What is extra, if you get a kitten today, in only a few quick months you may have a complete grown cat, a cat who will stay an average of 12 to 15 years. If you have the time, environment, and strength to elevate a kitten, through all way do it, it's a great revel in. Just keep in mind that kittens are high renovation. They demand a variety of interest. They want ordinary veterinary care consisting of booster photographs, worming, and spaying or neutering. Maximum all young kittens start out affectionate and passive, but they need some socialization and training to stay that way, and even still, you won't recognize what their adult personality may be like till they develop up. Finally, very young children and really young kittens normally do not blend nicely. It is nice to think that a toddler and a 10-week vintage kitten can grow up together, but it certainly doesn't occur that manner. In 6 months, that little ball of fur your baby could bring round will have grown into 10 pounds plus of adult cat, and your 3-year vintage might be 3.5 years vintage. Finding the proper cat, there may be clearly no chance of a cat shortage in these USA, there are masses of cats to head around after which some. In most components of the country, you may simply open your front door at sunup, and a cat might likely walk in before you completed breakfast. In fact, the range of cats around puts you in fairly of a predicament. How do you select the proper one? Will it be healthful? What approximately hidden fitness or conduct problems? What occurs to the cat if matters don't training session in your property? Getting a cat isn't always like getting a garden mower or a hairdryer, they do not include insurers. Everyone is going to be specific, which means precise joys and troubles include each cat. Nonetheless, resources for cats have to assist you decide. Although the source cannot promise the cat will by no means get ill, they could take steps to offer the cat the nice viable chances of staying well. Desirable resources for finding the right cat for you encompass friends and pals. The odds are someone has a cat or kittens in want of a domestic. Normally, taking a cat from a neighbor or friend works out excellent for everybody, especially if it's a kitten from your neighbor's cat's muddle or an allergic buddy's family puppy. Your personal relationship with this supply usually method you'll get the immediately story in this particular cat too. A couple of warnings about getting your cat from a pal or neighbor, although, don't count on the cat to have the sizable veterinary care that a cat from a safe haven or breeder has, and be cautious approximately mixing business and friendship. Animal shelters. Hundreds of thousands of homeless cats come to be being euthanized in animal shelters each 12 months. Adopting from a refuge saves a existence, makes room for some other cat, and is a cheaper manner to obtain a pet with low fee pictures and neutering. Be prepared to go through packages and interviews, some of which might appear a bit too private and pushy. Do not take it for my part, they have got suitable reasons for it. Additionally, make certain to check the centers and the circumstance of the adoptable pets. Because the animals live in close company, infection, worms, and fleas can be a trouble. Puppy Finders, www.petfinder.org, continues a database of cats available for adoption from local shelters. Breeders. If you need a purebred cat, this is the way to go. Good breeders are extraordinarily informed about cats in well-known and their breed specifically and are cautious about who they sell their cats to. Beware of bargain purebreds and basement breeders, folks who breed strictly for income. A good breeder is interested in keeping a superb animal, keeps cautious data, and typically best produces one or two litters per breeding lady in line with year. Ask for a breeder referral from countrywide breed institutions consisting of the Cat Fanciers Association, www.cfa.org. Stray cats. On occasion you do not even should worry approximately locating the right cat, the proper cat unearths you. Many folks swear that these are the excellent cats to have. There may be no adoption interviews or expenses while you take in a stray, and more than probably you're saving a lifestyles. On the other hand, you will need to cowl the fee of pictures, worming, neutering, and the like. Many strays produce other fitness problems that might not show up right away and can get expensive to deal with. Occasionally nearby humane societies will help out with initial vet care, or an area animal hospital may additionally provide decreased fees for treating a foundling cat, but do not count on it. Every other important decision you want to make when deciding on a cat is whether or not you'll have an indoor cat or an outside cat. Find out about the ramifications of each decision in the subsequent section. Choosing an indoor cat versus an out-of-doors cat, perhaps not anything is as pitiful because the wail of a cat who desires to be on the opposite side of a door. When it is the front door, many of us take that to mean that our cats won't be absolutely glad unless they move exterior. However, on the other hand, most cats make the equal form of racket after they need to return internal, or, for that rely, after they need to get through any door. Do cats actually need to move outside? Do they need to? Or even if the solution to both questions is, yes, is it truly of their satisfactory hobby? Do cats need to move outside like dogs? The principal reason puppies are walked is elimination, observed intently through exercising. Most effective the smallest puppies can get sufficient running indoors. Puppies are percent hunters, this means that they paintings cooperatively to run their quarry to exhaustion. That may take all day, because of this puppies have a herbal instinct to run, dot and run, dot and run. You want a variety of open space for that kind of paintings. Cats, however, are ambush hunters. They rely on rather brief bursts of very rapid walking. A hallway of any decent duration affords lots of room for that. That mixed with the instinct to bury wastes, that's why cats will use a muddle field, adds up to no pressing cause to take a cat outside. Is it natural for a cat to move out of doors? Of course, fresh air and sunshine are true for all people, human or cat. However, is the out-of-doors lifestyles without a doubt extra herbal on your cat? Sure, his wild ancestors lived outside. However, that became a few thousand years and several hundred generations in the past. To top all of it off, those ancestors lived inside the arid areas of the Mideast, a much cry from the climate and surroundings of America these days. As soon as cats had been domesticated, they stopped being absolutely herbal. After they were uprooted from their original habitat, they had to do their pleasant to adapt instincts honed over tens of heaps of years of living in middle Japanese deserts to their new situations. Some of those instances, the bitter cold of a Midwestern wintry weather, dogs and wild animals that will turn them from hunter to hunted, and dashing vehicles and vehicles, simply to name a few, they are able to in no way really adapt to. The no longer so exquisite outside, what is awaiting your cat simply outdoor your the front door? Sure, there are trees and grass and all the sights, sounds, smells, and joys of nature, correct matters for everybody to take pleasure in. But there also are vicious animals, merciless humans, traffic, disease, and animal control officials, who can be within their legal proper to seize and impound your cat, if he steps off your private home. The only dependable way to keep your cat secure from all of these deadly risks is to preserve him interior. Reality be told, United States of America cats aren't necessarily more secure exterior than town cats. Certain, there is a lot extra chance of being hit through a car or mauled by means of a stray dog inside the city. But out within the United States of America, we have were given a few predators that run larger, quicker, and savvier than a feral city canine. We've got also got less light at the roads, making strays tougher to see, and simpler to hit, and generally greater types of disease-bearing insects, inclusive of ticks. A whole host of significant and fatal tomcat sicknesses want contact with infected cats, or regions in which inflamed cats hang out plenty, to spread. Tomcat immunodeficiency virus, FIV, which causes a breakdown in the cat's sickness-fighting immune device, is mainly handed by way of bites from inflamed cats. And feline leukemia virus, FELV, normally calls for extended close touch with an infected cat, inclusive of sharing muddle containers or food and water bowls, or mutual grooming. Again and again, the dangers for sickness are minor or negligible for indoor cats, extensively better for out-of-doors or indoor-out-of-doors cats. Cat owners, specifically those with young kids, ought to be especially conscious that outside cats are more likely to pick up illnesses and parasites that can affect humans, from minor annoyances like fleas to greater severe illness like Lyme tick ailment to extraordinarily dangerous situations like rabies. Going out of doors competently simply as it's most secure in your cat to live interior and no longer roam free would not imply he can never see the mild of day except via the window. A leash and harness, no longer a collar, is a reasonably secure way for both you and your cat to get some sparkling air and sunshine. Taking walks on a leash is an obtained taste that a few cats will never acquire, though. Everyday revel in from kittenhood allows, and some leash-skilled cats can even request a walk. Of course, a cat on a leash is still at chance for selecting up fleas, and for encounters with unleashed cats and puppies within the community. Constructing a cat run is genuinely now not as difficult as it sounds. Runs ought to be enclosed on all sides, which includes the pinnacle, and solidly anchored and built. Monitors need to be the heaviest grade of outdoor mesh, and walls need to expand some inches below the floor to prevent cats from digging their manor out, or different animals from digging their manor in. If the run isn't constructed connected to your private home with a puppy door or different door leading interior, make certain it consists of a few sort of heated, waterproof safe haven for your cat to retreat to in case of inclement climate. It's mainly important for a run or different outdoor enclosure to have a roof. Cats are great climbers and leapers, or even an 8 to 10 foot wall may not keep them, especially if there are displays to hook onto. The roof and partitions of the run provide every other sort of protection, too, they hold different things out. Openings in the roof or partitions allow unfriendly or risky animals, human beings, and things into an area that your cat may not be able to break out. Free-roaming cats get into loud, overdue nighttime spats with other cats, bite or dig up acquaintances' plants, kill neighborhood birds, but also may additionally help manage the nearby rodent populace, and bury their wastes in different humans' gardens. While some parents, and some cat proprietors, see these as minor annoyances, many other parents see them as a lot extra severe problems. If your cat receives right into a combat, it can do extra than wake the acquaintances due to the yowling and screaming. The superficial scratches you can see on his face or back aren't so terrible. However, he may additionally have bite wounds that near up quickly, sealing in dirt and germs and growing a painful abscess several days later. Bites at some point of fights additionally seem to be the primary manner to spread pussycat immunodeficiency virus. Unaltered cats that roam unfastened additionally make contributions to pet overpopulation, a hassle that fills animal shelters to capability and past, resulting in tens of millions of dogs and cats being positioned to sleep every year. Now which you've selected an appropriate cat for you, it is time to discover ways to deal with it. We'll start in the next section with recommendations for feeding your cat. Cat feeding tips. You are what you eat may be a solid piece of sense that's even as true for your cat because it is for you. Feed your cat a top quality diet, and you're more likely to possess a healthy cat. The pet food industry is business, and with good reason. There are overflow 100 million dogs and cats living in American homes, plus who knows how many more in shelters, catteries, and kennels across the country. To top it all off, you've got thousands of individuals feeding strays. If you work, one cat can undergo some 90 pounds or more of cat chow during a year. We're talking about many dollars being spent annually, just to feed the kitty. Just like human food, there are some tasty feline treats that are good for cats and a few things that are basically food. An occasional snack of the not-so-healthy stuff shouldn't do any permanent harm, but don't make it a daily a part of your cat's diet. Can cats be vegetarians? The wild ancestors of the fashionable domestic cat were hunters, an instinct your cat still has. Whether Tabby is bringing you gifts of demised birds and mice or pouncing on a bit of lint, she's expressing a strong natural drive to stalk and kill prey. If you doubt that your cat may be a natural-born meat-eater and predator, just take an honest check out her teeth subsequent time she yawns. Those fangs aren't designed for eating alfalfa sprouts. The fact is your cat is such a lot of a carnivore, she can't survive as a vegetarian. There are certain nutrients found only in animal proteins that your cat needs. One among these nutrients is an aminoalkanoic acid called taurine. Without taurine, cats can go blind and develop enlarged hearts, which can likely give out on them well before their time. And in contrast to dogs, cats require a dietary source of vitamin A and a carboxylic acid called arachidonic acid found only in tissue. That's why you ought to never feed pet food to your cat. Pet food just doesn't have enough of the proper sorts of nutrients for cats. By the pound, it's going to be cheaper to feed pet food to your cat, but it could cost your cat her health, her sight, or maybe her life. Of course, that does not mean you ought to feed your cat meat or let her depend upon hunting as her only source of food. It has been many years since cats lived within the wild, so their hunting skills are quite a touch rusty. Plus, cats that hunt or eat raw or undercooked meat can devour several sorts of diseases, including some which may get passed on to you. Please eat the daisies if it's green and it grows from the bottom, the chances are some cat will attempt to eat it. This vegetarian quirk within the carnivorous cat's personality is especially worrisome if the plants in question are your prized houseplants, or worse, if they're poisonous to your cat. Many cat owners check out plant eating as a behavior problem, and it's if the cat is eating plants you do not want her to. Some folks assume that a cat who eats plants isn't getting enough of the proper sorts of food in her diet. They're right, too, but only within the sense that what the cat needs more of in her diet is plants. The experts have a couple of ideas why cats eat plants. It might be to urge some trace nutrients, to assist with digestion, or as an emetic to assist mention swallowed hair and other non-food items. Regardless of the reason, eating vegetation is an instinctive behavior in cats, you cannot stop it. Therefore the neatest thing to try to do is point the behavior during a direction you'll both accept. Plant a cat garden. You'll find ready-made kits in pet shops and catalogs, but a more economical choice is to only roll in the hay yourself. If you're handy, you would possibly build a flowery container out of wood, otherwise you can just use something available. Whatever you are doing, confirm you plant your cat garden during a container that does not tip or move easily. All you would like is simply a few of inches of excellent potting soil and a few seeds. Oat grass or catnip are good choices. You would possibly want to stay the garden out of reach from your cats while your crop is arising, but once the greens are a couple of inches tall, set it out and let Tabby munch at will. Get your plants out of reach. Cats are incredibly good climbers and leapers, so putting your houseplants on stands or shelves probably won't help much. Mantles, windowsills, and therefore the like are easy landing pads for feline acrobats. Hang plants from the ceiling, put them behind cat-proof barriers on a sun parlor closed off by glass doors, for example, or set them in locations that your cat absolutely can't jump, climb, or crawl to. Shield your plants. If you cannot get your plants out of kitty's reach, try forming a protective shield around your plants. Placing net plant markers, or maybe mothballs within the soil around your plant may safeguard it from prying paws, but these barriers aren't so pretty to seem at. Try adding some Spanish moss round the base of your plant to stay your cat away. Sometimes, spraying bitters on the leaves will discourage a cat from chewing. Other times, though, putting some bad-tasting substance on a plant does more harm to the plant than the cat's teeth. Kitty snacks and people food. A well-fed cat doesn't got to snack between meals any longer than you are doing. Too frequent snacks will have an equivalent effect on your cat that it can wear you, unhealthy weight gain and an imbalanced diet. Of course, it's hard to resist the temptation to offer your feline pal a treat now then, and it's perfectly all right to offer in there too temptation, assuming there is a long enough stretch of your time between now then. How long of a time depends on your cat and therefore the sorts of treats you give her. If your cat remains eating the recommended amount of a top quality cat chow a day and is not overweight, then you're probably not giving her too many treats. If, on the opposite hand, your cat is chowing down on tasty but not so nutritious snacks and is either getting plumper or turning her nose up at dinner, it is time to vary your strategy. Store-bought cat treats tend to not be full of good nutrition. Their main purpose is that the same as human treats, to taste good, real good, and that is about it. Gourmet cat snacks usually have fewer artificial colors and fillers in them but still aren't meant to be fed as a daily a part of tabby's diet. The great thing about gourmet treats is that the cost, they're usually so expensive that cat owners won't overfeed them to their cats. A question vets hear all the time is, can I feed my cat people food? There's little or no that folks eat that cats shouldn't or won't, so that's not really such a lot of a drag. Cat owners should take care about feeding dairy products to their pets. Although cats love dairy products, many do not digest them well and should get sick. The question once more is nutritional balance. A bit like with home cooking, feeding your cat leftovers or using people food for snacks might not be providing her with the proper nutrients within the right amounts. Still, people food might provide a number of the healthiest snacks for cats. If you give your cat some scrambled eggs or a few of pieces of pasta, a minimum of you recognize what's in it. And you would possibly be surprised what your cat will eat. Cat owners report their pets begging for predictable tidbits like fish and chicken also as unexpected ones, including tomatoes and cantaloupe. Water, water everywhere. Your cat needs about an oz of water per pound of weight a day. That does not sound like much, but it adds up. An average-size cat would wish 2 quarts of water hebdomadally. Of course, cats get water by drinking. But there's another important source of water for your cat, the food she eats. The more water there's in her food, the less she must drink. Canned cat chow is costlier because you're buying water alongside the food. Up to 75% of wet cat chow is water, and paying a touch more for the container. Dry cat chow has much less water, perhaps 10% by weight, which suggests a cat whose diet consists of only dry food has got to drink tons more. Dehydration, not enough water within the body, may be a significant issue for any living creature, and cats are especially susceptible to it. A cat can go without food for days, losing up to 40% of her weight, and still survive. But a loss of body water of only 10 to 15% can kill her. Other liquids, like milk, if it doesn't make your cat sick, are an honest source of water, but nothing beats the important thing. Make certain your cat has many clean, water available in the least times. We will conclude our examination of cat chow with a discussion of store-bought cat chow versus homemade cat foods within the next section. Shop-sold cat meals versus self-made cat meals. The nice element about a home-cooked meal is you're the one who receives to decide what is in it. If you're a steak and potatoes kind, then you will broil up a pleasant lean porterhouse and a batch of new reds. However, in case you move for a green salad, you may pick out your dinner fresh from the lawn. Looking to cut down on cholesterol and salt? Whilst you're the cook, you make the call. Until you are a nutritionist or dietitian, however, you should let the professionals, the most important pet food producers, put together the main portion of Kitty's food plan. Running out the right quantities and stability of ingredients is a difficult venture. Maximum food can get lumped into one or more of three categories of nutrition: protein, fat, and carbohydrate. Special kinds of animals, consisting of humans, want unique proportions of protein, fats, and carbohydrate in their diets. It is some other cause why dog meals isn't always precise for cats. Dogs and cats need special percentages of fats and protein to stay healthful. What's extra? The ones needs alternate for the duration of an animal's lifestyles. A kitten has unique dietary needs than an grown-up cat, and they both have specific wishes than an vintage codger cat. Most puppy meals businesses have special formulation for different stages of age and activity, and there's a whole line of prescription diets for cats with diverse fitness issues. We've all visible a cat come running at the sound of a can opener. There is absolute confidence that Kitty loves getting canned meals. However, is canned food better for cats than dry food? Not always. Every type of food has its advantages and disadvantages. The maximum important element is whether or not the food meets your cat's nutritional desires, of path, your price range and your cat's preference additionally play a function in which type of meals you need to pick. Keep bought cat meals as available in three trendy bureaucracy. Dry cat food is also called kibble. It's simply what it feels like, crunchy nuggets or kernels of meals. Dry pet food can be stored for a long term in a rodent evidence bin if you have problems with mice, has no smell, and programs may be kept at room temperature for weeks without spoiling. Canned or wet cat meals has a reasonably long shelf lifestyles, as lengthy as it's unopened. Once you open the can, even though, it does not keep up thoroughly. Moist cat food typically has a smelly smell and tends to be a touch bit messy to handle. If you feed your cat wet meals, any uneaten meals must be picked up and discarded after 15 to 20 minutes. It is a breeding ground for bacteria which can make your cat ill. Unused portions of newly opened cans may be refrigerated in an airtight box for as much as an afternoon or semi-moist cat food also includes man or woman nuggets, but without the crunch of dry meals. It is typically packaged in sealed canisters or character meal length foil pouches and is surprisingly processed. A few semi-moist cat ingredients are formed into thrilling shapes or dyed extraordinary shades. Semi-moist ingredients in resealable boxes hold properly at room temperature. Every of these forms of foods has its sturdy points and vulnerable points. As an example, dry food is convenient, budget-friendly, and may be not noted all day. Alternatively, the way some dry meals are formulated appears to inspire the formation of bladder stones. The wealthy aromas of canned food will tempt even the maximum finicky eater, but the crunchiness of dry meals facilitates prevent dental plaque. Semi-moist combines the ease of dry food with the tastiness of canned food, but may additionally comprise the most non-food fillers and dyes. All logo call cat meals covers the primary dietary desires of your average cat. But if you're concerned about the overall high quality of the packing containers, luggage, and cans of pussycat food in the pet substances aisle of your local market, you might need to don't forget one of the premium logo meals, usually determined simplest in pet stores or through veterinarians. Feeding your cat keep bought food guarantees that she is getting the vitamins she desires. On the equal time, a home-cooked supplement for your cat's everyday diet is okay in case you make certain the meals you choose are appropriate for cats. There may be not anything wrong with getting the maximum out of an entire fryer by cooking up the gizzards for the cat, unless they grow to be the important part of Tabby's eating regimen. You see, organ meats, kidney, belly, and even liver are all right for your cat moderately, but they've been related to fitness problems if your cat eats too much of them. Likewise, every cat in the world loves milk and cheese, however most cats have trouble digesting them well. In the subsequent section, we will cover every other very essential factor of cat ownership, grooming. What is in cat meals? Careful customers are label readers, and that is a terrific area to start in identifying simply what you are feeding your cat when you buy cat meals. Many pet owners compare the nutrition data on one-of-a-kind brands of pet meals and be aware that a much less steeply priced brand has the identical nutrients as a top-rate cat food. What that simply approach is that the one's two meals fit up within the laboratory. As an instance, vintage shoe leather might price as high as lean bird breasts in protein content material. Of course, you and your cat would both as a substitute eat bird. So, what you need to realize is how the various vitamins in shape up to your cat. You see, it is now not how an awful lot of a specific nutrient there may be in a can of cat food that matters, but how tons your cat's digestive device can take up. Reasonably priced foods are usually crafted from cheap elements, which your cat might not digest nicely. Just due to the fact your cat gobbles it up and yowls for greater would not mean a meals as ideal for her. Think about youngsters and junk meals. The ethical of the story is brand call and distinctiveness. Pet meals are made via organizations that do plenty of research into puppy vitamins. They're constantly improving their foods to preserve pace with the contemporary data, and they use first-class substances which have vitamins your cat can use. It may cost a little extra, however it is worth it.